it's very clear that that it's a kind of portrait of a city in general, as the cities in a way show very clearly and more than anything else probably the way we live together, the culture we have, the in the cities you can see, if you are able to read the cities, you can see the triumph and the terrible failures. And of course, the surrogate city is not a portrait of a particular city, but it tries to translate into music the city as a phenomenon, culturally, aesthetically, historically, from the side of the architecture, from all different sides.
Yeah, I think surrogate cities, or also the word surrogate, is very much dedicated to the ambivalence of living in a city. Because of course you lose a couple of things of idyllic home imaginations and desires, which you might connect with living on the countryside. So there's certain things you don't have in a city, but you have other things instead. You have also controversial experiences. You have, you are in a permanent discussion and conflict and exchange with others. You are never alone, even if you want to. But at the same time, you have a lot of distance, maybe to even to your neighbors. So all in all, I'm always was a city person in all my life, and I think it's the most contemporary way of being able to adapt to the world as it is. And we see also when we look at the political landscape that the urban populations, they have a more liberal, a more contemporary, a more open attitude towards the other, towards those whom we don't know. And so I think actually the city is more an utopic way of living. And what I want to do with this piece is actually to offer this discourse, this discussion, these mixed feelings about your individual way of experience in the city, to offer that with music.
You have to know that Heiner Goebbels, in his other works, is a very important figure for music theater. So he really, with his theater works or music theater works, he really developed the idea what music theater is and can be. He really brought it to a new level. Concerning my role as a conductor, it's a bit particularly with that piece, because I have also very sentimental feelings about it, because I conducted that piece and did the first performance while I was still very young a greenhorn in conducting. So he gave me the chance to present myself as a conductor with that piece. So it's a bit part of my biography.